Did you know that the Dygma Defy is the first ever split columnar keyboard that allows wired, low latency radio frequency and Bluetooth connectivity? That's right, the first ever. But to truly harness the power a Dygma Defy holds, you're going to want to make sure you've nailed the setup of this absolute one-of-a-kind ergonomic keyboard. Because if you don't, you might be missing out on some of the secret features included. Welcome, Digmates! I'm Dominique, also known as Digma Dom, Dynamite Dominique, Dino Dommy, or the Big D. This video is all about setting up your Dygma Defy. Before we jump in, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll receive a chocolate treat for every new subscriber this video gets. As you already know, the Dygma Defy can be used both wired and wireless. So we figured we'd very quickly start out with the wired setup. If you ordered a wired Dygma Defy, you will receive this neuron. This really doesn't require too much explanation. Take the wires out of the box, plug the USB-C cable into your computer, and connect it to the neuron. For those of you who don't have a USB-C on your computer, a USB-C to A adapter is included with the Defy. Then connect both halves of the keyboard to the neuron. Make sure the left port is connected to the left and the right to the right. If you ordered a wireless Dygma Defy, you will get this neuron. When connecting your computer to the neuron, it's important to connect the USB-C cable to the wider end of the neuron. The neuron simply won't work unless you connect it via this port. Then connect the neuron to each half of the Dygma Defy. These can be plugged into any remaining available port. The keyboard should now light up to show a connection has been made. Keep in mind that the Dygma Defy holds the same amount of power and data as a futuristic spaceship control panel. So only use the cables provided upon purchase. Now, you may think that when wired, this is ultimately a plug-and-play style keyboard, but due to its unique key disposition, especially involving the thumb keys, and since this is a fully programmable keyboard, it's not that simple. Functions such as space, backspace, enter, and certain modifier keys will be either located on the thumb keys or in the inner or outer keys. The next step is to download Bazecor, the configurator software of the Dygma keyboards. Head over to Dygma.com and download the latest version of Bazecor. Make sure you check the firmware version of your Defy as well, which can be found on the left menu called Firmware Update. If there's a new firmware version available, follow the on-screen instructions and update your keyboard. Remember, when updating your keyboard's firmware, you need to use the cables, even if you have the wireless version. And that's my segue to talk about the wireless setup. As I said earlier, if you have the wireless version, you'll get this neuron. Let's explore the two wireless features the Dygma Defy offers: RF and Bluetooth, starting with low latency radio frequency, or RF. If you were to unplug both halves of the Dygma Defy while keeping the neuron plugged into your computer and then flip the little switch on the back to wireless mode, this will allow you to work or game using low latency RF. Just to note, your keyboard may briefly blink red after unplugging, but this just means it's making a saucy little love connection with your neuron. Let's move on to our favorite feature of the Dygma Defy, Bluetooth connectivity. For Bluetooth to work, the first thing you need to do is completely unplug your neuron from your computer. Then, making sure that the little wireless switch is flipped to wireless mode, plug the neuron directly into the base of the Dygma Defy. Once plugged, you'll see the number rows light up in navy blue. Each number equals one device. Let's begin by pressing the number one. You'll see the number one start to pulse after pressed. This means it's looking for a device to connect to. Head over to the Bluetooth settings on the device you'd like to connect and team it up with the Dygma Defy. Once connected, the number one will change from navy blue to white. You're now connected and can begin working like a Bluetooth madman. If you'd like to connect more devices, simply head over to Bazecor, locate the wireless option, then assign a key as your preferred Bluetooth pairing mode key. Think of this as a Bluetooth pairing mode layer. Just a little side note, syncing Bazecor with your keyboard doesn't yet work via Bluetooth. When modifying your Bazecor settings, always use wires or RF for full synchronization. Now you can follow the same method for connecting up to 5 devices to your Dygma Defy and access your Bluetooth devices at any time. These are the following color codes while pairing devices. Blue keys represent available channels, white keys represent assigned channels, and the green key represents the currently active channel. You can switch through your devices at the tap of a key. If you'd like to reset a channel, simply hold the red key underneath the assigned channel number until it turns back to an unassigned blue. It may also be important to select Forget this device on your computer so that everything is reset. Finally, let's briefly touch on charging and battery management. There's a separate battery in each half of the wireless Dygma Defy, which charges independently when plugged into your computer. If you leave in the cables and it becomes 100% charged, it bypasses the charging. This ensures that your batteries never overcharge. To check the battery level of each half of your keyboard, head over to Bazecor and check the battery menu at the bottom left corner. When you hover over it, you can see your battery levels. Or make your life simpler by adding a battery status key on your Defy. You'll be able to see the battery level of your keyboard or if it's charging. One red LED means it's less than 10%, one green LED means it's less than 40%, two means between 40 and 70%, and three green LEDs mean above 70%. If you want to save up on battery life, you can always adjust the LED brightness of the Defy when it's on wireless mode. If you have any questions about the Dygma Defy, the Dygma Rays, this video, another video, or the observable universe, please let us know in the comments below. We're always happy to answer your questions. Thanks for watching!